Morning, everybody. Today is Wednesday, December 6th, so fortunately, my plans in Japan is about to end, so I'm planning on leaving tomorrow. But for the most part, I'm at a bus stop right now, taking the bus for the first time here in Japan. And we're actually heading to Menya Itto, which is arguably one of the best ramen places in Japan, according to Tabelog, of course, which is their rating website. It even scores higher than Nakiryu and Tsuta. So once you get into the bus, so what we did was I went to the front, I scanned my transportation card, and then just sat back down. So I'm going to be using Google Maps in order to get to Menya Itto, but the problem is that not all the stops are translated in English, but this is not a huge problem. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at the last bus stop and I'm going to match up the Japanese characters, and there's going to be a screen on this bus that tells you what bus stop is coming next. So I'm just going to match that up and that's how I'm going to know where to get off at. Alright, we're getting off the next station, so I think we press this. Oh, it's this button. And then we'll get off the next station. So we're off the bus, and then now we're at the train station, so I have to take it for about two stops. But what I'm worried about is that I'm actually quite late. Usually I like to get an hour early in advance, but right now it's about 10:15, so I probably won't get there until about 10:25. And the place opens at 11. So Menya Itto is really known for their Tsukemen, which is like a dipping ramen. So I'm pretty excited to try this. I haven't had Tsukemen yet, but basically it's like deconstructed ramen if you think about it. So we just arrived at Menya Itto, and luckily for me there's not too many people here, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to wait in line, and eventually it's going to be our turn in order to go in and place an order. Once you're inside, you're going to notice a vending machine on the right, and on the left of the vending machine there's going to be a sign that's in English and Japanese that tells you all their bestsellers. So in this case, the chicken tsukemen is their number one, which is their bestseller, and it's also marked on the vending machine. In order to use this vending machine, you're going to insert cash in here and then you're going to select your item, and once you have selected, a ticket and your change will pop out at the bottom. So you're going to hand over the ticket to the staff member that's waiting next to the machine, and then head back outside to the spot where you're at until they call you inside. Once you get seated inside Menya Itto, you may notice a couple things. One being is the restaurant's not very big, so it only seats around 11 people. That's why the line can be long from time to time. Another thing is that the restaurant is pretty quiet, so the only thing that you really hear while you're inside the restaurant is the chef preparing your food, the radio that's playing in the background, and the third thing you're gonna hear is everybody just slurping up their meal, so it's basically ASMR in real time. The dish that I order is the rich seafood chicken tsukemen, which is their number one bestseller. And if you don't know what tsukemen is, I would basically describe it as a deconstructed ramen. So instead of having the broth in the ramen, you have a separate bowl for the broth, which is in a more concentrated form. So there are a few ways in order to eat tsukemen. So I saw one customer dump the entire bowl of the broth into his noodles. So you can do it that way. But the other way is to take the noodles and then just dip it into the tsukemen broth. And once you have the noodles coated in this delicious rich broth, you're gonna want to slurp up these noodles pretty quick. These noodles here are absolutely fantastic. So these noodles kind of remind me of udon, seeing how they're pretty thick, and you also get a huge portion of them. So they're super soft, they're also a little firm on the inside, and they have a nice chewy bite to it. It's phenomenal with this broth. Also, if you look inside the tsukemen broth, you're gonna see that there's chicken meatballs in here, and there's also pieces of pork belly as well in here. This entire meal gives you tons of meat, tons of noodles, a rich, delicious broth, all for 1,080 yen. It's definitely worth it by far. However, I did feel a little bit rushed while eating here, but this is because I recorded, so I was the second to last person to finish my meal out of 11. But if I didn't record, I would probably have been in 8th place out of 11. If I had to rate myself on how quick I eat, I would have to say that I'm a pretty quick eater, but I definitely felt rushed here. Or maybe I was just unlucky that the guy sitting next to me finished his meal within 5 minutes. So I was so surprised that he just slurped it down. I don't even know if he chewed, but I definitely felt like I was eating super slow the moment he got up and left.
Arguably one of the best deconstructed ramens I ever had. Like, this place was really good. I'm blown away by like quality of the noodles, the broth. Oh, all the toppings were delicious. And then here is the line. Like, for the most part, Good thing I came a little bit early, but not super early. But I came on a weekday, so if you come on a weekend, I'm sure the lines must be longer. But this was definitely worth it for me. Oh, probably one of the top meals that I've had in Tokyo, like by far. But the tsukemen was delicious. The broth with the noodles for it, where you dipped into it, very good. And then the meat as well, juicy, tender, fatty, rich. And you get such thick cuts too, like the pork belly, it was like this thick. Like both at most ramen places, they give you like a thin slice, but you know, I like it when they give big portions. Like, I love eating meat. Oh, so good. The marinated egg was very good, so you taste a little bit of soy sauce, and then you get this delicious, rich, gooey, yummy yolk. But for the most part, this was a phenomenal experience. But we're gonna head back and then do a little bit of shopping, and then I definitely have to book my flight and hotel to Taipei.
So we're at Supermarket Ozeki.
So this is like a grocery store. I saw two bottles of alcohol that I saw yesterday or the other day, but they have produce here, and they're also selling the white strawberries from Japan. So I'm actually gonna pick up a pack because these seems more reasonable, about $5 for a pack instead of $25 that I saw previously. They'll look roughly about the same. Take a look under. Oh, this one looks stuffed. We should get the stuffed one, huh? Yeah, let's get the stuffed bag. Like, normally I don't see persimmons this size, but we're gonna get one. Because when we usually get persimmons, they're not like super fat like this. They're more like along the size of the orange, but look at this size in comparison. Super huge. We're gonna get one. You can also get sushi here too. So if you want supermarket sushi, pretty much any supermarket will have it cut up. It's normal. So prices are around $4 for the sashimi. This one's $5, but it's a bigger plate. Okay, we're at the whiskey aisle. So American whiskey. Yes, they do have it. So I've been looking for this everywhere. Nika whiskey from the barrel. Everywhere it's been sold out. But I remember seeing two bottles here and I should have just picked it up from here. So it's about 2,300 yen for a bottle. And then now it's sold out. We picked up the last two bottles. Alright, so we just finished shopping at Ozeki, but now I'm back inside the heart of Asakusa, basically near the temple area. And there's tons of awesome shops here to buy souvenirs for, but I'm also gonna try a couple places that I've been meaning to go to before I leave Japan. So after we head to a couple of those places, I'm pretty much gonna go back to the guest house and then just pack for the remainder of the day.